Welcome, dear students, to the lecture in which we are going to discuss the hybridization in PCl5. The hybridization in PCl5 is sp3d hybridization. It is not dsp3. So there is difference between these two. Hybridization is sp3d. It is not dsp3. Why? Because sp3d is the hybridization in which d orbital of the valence shell takes part in the mixing. But if you will write down it as dsp3, it means that the d orbital of the second last shell is taking part in the mixing process. So in PCl5, the d orbital of the valence shell takes part in the mixing. So that will be considered as the sp3d hybridization. Now, my dear students, phosphorus belongs to group 5a. It is a member of the nitrogen family. So it will be having 5 valence electrons. Atomic number of phosphorus is 15. Its electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, and 3p3. We will write down it down as this one electron on all 3p. This is the electronic configuration of phosphorus in ground state, in which it has 3 unpaired electrons. It means it is trivalent in nature. But phosphorus, in case of PCl5, it will form 5 bonds with the chlorine. It means we will consider its electronic configuration in the excited state. One electron from 3s will move to one d orbital of the third shell. Now, according to the normal electronic configuration, after 3p, there must be 4s, and then there should be 3d, and you know there are 5 degenerate orbitals after d. We will write down at 3dz². Electron will not move from 3s to 4s because of the large gap of the energy. If the electron moves from 3s to 4s, the shell will be changed. Means the electron from s of the third shell will move to the s of the fourth shell. But due to large energy gap between these two, the electronic transition will take place within the third shell, and the electron will move from s of the third shell to the d of the third shell, and it will remain empty. Now, my dear students, in this case, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it has 5 unpaired electrons, so it will show pentavalency, and that is the excited state electronic configuration of phosphorus. Now, all these orbitals means 3s1, 3px1, 3py1, 3pz1, and 3dz²1. These all atomic orbitals, 1s, 3p, and 1d, they will take part in the mixing process. So they will get mixed. You know, in hybridization, the atomic orbitals, they are mixed, not the electrons. So electronic configuration in the atomic orbital and hybrid orbitals, that remain same. If all the atomic orbitals that are mixing, they contain one electron each, then all the hybrid orbitals produced, they will also be having one electron each. So there will be total 5 sp3d HO hybrid orbitals will produce. They have different shape and energy, and they will be having all same shape and same energy. Now these five will get arranged around the central phosphorus. In basically trigonal, bipyramidal fashion. So they will arrange around the central phosphorus in this form, and every one of them they will be having one electron that will be half filled. Now in order to form a pair, they will overlap with p orbital of chlorine . This one is the 3pz one of the chlorine, and one electron from sp3d and one electron of the 3pz of the chlorine. You can write down the electronic configuration of chlorine. You will see that there will be one unpaired electron in 3pz, and that 3pz basically overlaps. Now what kind of overlap it will be? It will be sp3d pz overlap, because the overlapping orbital, one of them is sp3d and other is the pz. As a result of this overlapping, one electron from each orbital, so there will be a pair formed, and when the pair forms, it means the sigma bond will form between the phosphorus and all five chlorine atoms. So there will be five overlaps and five sigma bonds will be produced. Now my dear students, the geometry of PCl5 will be something like that. That will be trigonal bipyramidal. Its electronic geometry and molecular geometry or molecular shape both will be same, and they will be trigonal bipyramidal. Now these chlorine atoms, these three chlorine atoms, they will be present in one plane, so they will be, these three bonds will be equatorial bonds. And the angle between these will be obviously 120, 120 and 120, there will be 360. So bond angle here, that will be 120 degree. While these two chlorine atoms, these two bonds, they will not be in the same plane as these three chlorine atoms. So they will be called as the axial bonds. And the angle of these with this equatorial plane, that will be 90 degree. So equatorial bonds are 3, axial bonds are 2. They are oriented at 120 degree and they are oriented at 90 degree. So there are, the overall geometry will be trigonal, bipyramidal, and the angles will be 90 and 120 degrees. My dear students, the PCl5, that is highly reactive. Why it is highly reactive? Because the bond length of the axial bonds, that is more as compared to the equatorial bonds. Why the bond length of these axial bonds is more? Due to the greater bond pair repulsion of these equatorial bonds. So these three bond pairs, they repel these axial bond pair of the electrons very highly, and due to this high repulsion of the bond pairs of the equatorial bonds, the bond length of the axial bonds increase, And because the axial bonds, they are longer bonds, they are unstable bonds. As the bond length increases, the bond strength decreases. So because of these longer bonds, these unstable bonds, the PCl5 that shows high reactivity. So the electronic and molecular geometry both will be same, because if a molecule has no lone pair of electrons, then its electronic and molecular geometry both are same, and that will be trigonal bipyramidal. So that was the sp3d hybridization of the PCl5. If you feel any problem, don't hesitate to ask in the comment section. I will answer that. Take care.